Now, to help us make sense of the market today, we are now joined by Ed Francisco of BDO Capital. Good afternoon, Sir Ed, and thank you so much for joining the program.
Hi, Rica. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Looking back at what happened last year, the numbers were in the red, but this week proves to be a good one. The PSEI is up over 1%. We're continuing the ascent for the fourth straight day. Do you think, Sir Ed, that there is more room to go higher, or is a pullback expected soon?
From the fundamental side, the Philippines has room to go higher. Mm-hmm. I am just a little cautious because we're waiting for next week's Fed, diba? If they increase 75 basis points, and I want to see what the reaction of our monetary board central bank will do. The governor has mentioned that they might match it. If they match it, then I think the rally will continue and be sustained. If they don't match it, then the peso might depreciate and there might be some pullback because some of the investors might, foreign investors might take out some of the hot money. Mm-hmm. So we'll see.
Mm-hmm. Do you think that we have to match it point by point, or do you think even at least a little difference would make a huge gap between the peso and the dollar?
Yeah, good question. In the past, our government has not necessarily wanted to match it point by point. Mm-hmm. I was with both the Secretary of Finance and the BSP governor Monday for a conference. And I think they alluded to the fact that they might match point by point now, and they are willing to defend the peso. So that's good news also for us.
Mm-hmm. Something that actually a lot of people are looking at. Now, let's look at the economy of the country. We're projected to grow 6.5% this year, despite the rising inflation. What do you think is your own forecast for this?
Yeah, I think the BDO view is still positive. We believe it's doable. Of course, prices are going up. Inflation is, of course, the concern. But when we walk in our malls, when we see the traffic the people in the restaurants lining up, it's very positive. So we really have a fighting chance. Our corporate earnings are positive. When we talk to our clients, there's good growth. It's sustained. People at least are still consuming. So I'm very positive I'm hopeful that we will reach or even exceed our targets this year.
Mm-hmm. Do you think, Sir Ed, that the BSP's move to defend the peso is enough to counter the inflation, or should we be doing something else?
The BSP mentioned anyway that they have several tools in their war chest. The $10 billion that they're willing to use is just one of them. And of course, there will be inward remittances of another, hopefully in 15, 16 billion in the last quarter, which is historical. So that will also hopefully reduce pressure on the peso. But in addition to that, they have other tools that we're willing to do. So it's not just defending the peso, but there are other measures. So I think they can defend it at least for the next 3 months. And then hopefully things will settle down, inflation will normalize across the world, and there'll be less pressure on the peso then. So at least for this next quarter, unless there's a concerted effort outside by these punters who want to really test the peso, I think defending it and keeping it below 60 is very doable.
Mm-hmm. Such a positive outlook coming from you. Let's look at the corporate front now, Sir Ed. Globe is boasting that they're the country's largest telco, and it's also because they're trying to diversify from being a pure telco player to a tech-based solutions provider. Not only that, we also have news of Henry C. Jr. teaming up with Elon Musk's SpaceX. Your thoughts on this, please, and on telco stocks right now.
Okay. Telco stocks I've always been very positive on because they are basically very resilient in this pandemic. And in fact, they've been continuing to grow as we needed more data, as we have worked from the home, our homes, and we needed to be in touch with the rest of the world. Mm-hmm. Right? So positive, whether it be Glow, whether it be PLDT, whether it be Converge, I'm optimistic with that. And then if you remember, both Globe and PLDT sold telecom towers this year, one after the other, and they also had one-off substantial gains. So Aeng as being a dominant, they've always been dominant in data. They have a different strategy from PLDT. PLDT had their own niche anyway. So I support the fact that, yeah, they're really the largest telco and non-cash, right? Non-telco because of GCash, which is doing well, and with the, as reported, there's increased number of subscribers. Mm-hmm. So more power to both Globe and PLDT, and then hopefully also Dito gets, you know, fixes its problems, because a third telco is also welcome.
Mm-hmm. That just got me a little curious, Sir Ed. Without naming names, do you have a certain favorite among the three, and can you tell us why?
I have two favorites at least, for those of you, at least, who want to be protected, who want good dividends, then two names will do you very well in the next few months of volatility. If you buy them, you'll have a good dividend, even with increasing yields. So at least you're protected, and you'll have annuity dividends. So that's key. And then, sorry, you asked about SpaceX. Anyway, the tie-up, of course, that's related to they're my shareholders in a way.
Let's see if we
big boy and a yeah. Fantastic.
Yeah, okay. We got you back again, Sir Ed. Thank you. Please continue.
Oh, sorry. No, regarding the SpaceX, I'm just optimistic because
we're losing Sir Ed's
Mr. Big Boy CEO. Yeah.
All right, we got frozen. You back again. Go ahead, frozen. Please.
Sorry to be frozen, but I'm just optimistic on SpaceX with Anthony Almeida and Mr. Big Boy C's investments. I'm sure they're very prudent investors, and it's really needed in the countryside and in the missionary areas. So as long as it's economically viable, it'll be good for the country, because I've also been in touch with the DICT, and they really want to ensure that there's this national broadband strategy in place, and the SpaceX tie-up is one of the mechanisms to ensure that.
Mm-hmm. All right, BDO Capital is the underwriter for Prime Infra's IPO. You've confirmed that it was postponed due to market volatility. Do you expect the IPO market to be more challenging for the rest of the year?
For at least the rest of the year, it's just really, 2-3 months left. Mm-hmm. It's really going to be challenging. So the other deal we're working with Secretary Perez, we hope it will push through, but we're still working on that. But yes, it's very challenging, especially for international deals or large deals like that of Mr. Razon. But I'm glad that you featured that 20-year tie-up they had with TerraPower, because that's a key subsidiary of Prime. We're very positive still on Prime and what they can do because of Mr. Lucci, the president. Believe in him. So it's just a matter of timing. If not the early next year, maybe later on. But as long as the market is right, Terra Prime has a very good name, have good prospects and good business portfolio that they're developing.
All right. And with that, I will let you go. Thank you for your market guidance and for your tips earlier, Sir Ed Francisco of BDO Capital. Thank you so much, sir. You have a good afternoon.